Hi friends, once again back to biology exams for you.com. In this video we are going to discuss about what are photosystems, what are the major differences between photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 in detail. Inside the chloroplast there are membranous sacs that is stacked one above the other, which is called as grana, and this is a grana and which is a site of light reaction. So this is a thylakoid membrane. Let us zoom in this region. So this is a thylakoid membrane. On the thylakoid membrane, photosystems and all other associated electron carriers and proteins are located. Or thylakoid membrane is a site of light dependent reaction. Photosystems are also located on the thylakoid membrane. These are the photosystems, photosystem 2 and photosystem 1. And this is a picture of non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So photosystems are light harvesting complexes that is made up of pigment molecules, accessory pigments and associated proteins. Photosystems are located on the thylakoid membrane of the chloroplast in the case of green plants and algae, whereas in the case of bacterium, these photosystems are located on the cell membrane. Let us zoom in this region. Each photosystem consists of two closely linked components, that is a reaction center chlorophyll A molecule and accessory pigment, which is called as antennae molecules. Accessory pigments include chlorophyll B, carotene, xanthophyll, etc. What is happening is this energy of sunlight or photons is received by these accessory pigments. These accessory pigments transfer this energy to other molecules, to the adjacent pigment molecules, by means of resonance transfer, which is a kind of vibratory transfer mechanism. Ultimately, this energy is channeled into the reaction center chlorophyll A molecule, from where electrons are moved from ground state to the excited state, that is received by electron acceptor, and that moves through different electron carriers providing energy for the creation of electron gradient ultimately the synthesis of ATP and NADPH. And we have discussed that part in the video cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation in detail. So in summary, these are the functions of photosystem. It is involved in light absorption, transfer of energy and ultimately transfer of electrons. Let us move into the difference. First of all, starting with difference in absorption peak. So photosystem 1, maximum absorption is 700 nanometer or farad region of light, or it absorbs longer wavelength of light, and it has an iron sulfur type reaction center and is rich in chlorophyll A. In the case of photosystem 2, maximum absorption peak is at 680 nanometer. It has a quinone-type reaction center and is rich in chlorophyll B. Second difference is it's regarding the location inside the chloroplast. There are two regions which is called as appressed and non-appressed region in chloroplast. So let's zoom in this region, and this is the granum, and individual units are called as thylakoid membrane. So photosystem 1 in green color is located on the non-appressed granule region, and this is a non-appressed granule region, or the region that is exposed to stroma. The region that is exposed to stroma, or it can be called as the outer layers of grana. So photosystem 1 in green color, that is primarily or that is located on the non-appressed granule region and also on the stroma lamellae that connects the adjacent grana. Whereas photosystem 2 is located on the appressed granule region. This is the appressed region. You can see here there is stacking or the internal part of the granum. Photosystem 2 is with green and black color, and this is seen on the internal part of granum or the appressed region of granum. Difference number 3, that is regarding the role in light reaction. Photosystem 1, that is involved in both cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. In cyclic photophosphorylation, photosystem 1 contributes to the formation of ATP. Electrons returns back to photosystem 1. Whereas in non-cyclic, electrons are received from photosystem 2 and it forms NADPH. Whereas in the case of photosystem 2, it is only involved in non-cyclic photophosphorylation and also involved in a process called as photolysis of water. As these electrons, when moves from photosystem 2, there is an electron hole. So in order to refill that electron hole, a process occurs that is called as a photolysis of water or water splitting, providing electrons and protons. It is involved in ATP synthesis. And that's it. Thank you so much for your support. You are with bduvU.com.